I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say, I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say, I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. Here we go. We're reading God's word. We're doing what we heard. We're spreading God's love from John chapter 3. We're memorizing scripture. We don't hide it in our hearts. And when we're old, we will never depart. Why? I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB set. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB set. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. Righteous seed is who we strive to be. KB kids affecting the world around us positively. We are growing day by day. We are watching what we say. We are kingdom builder kids and we're here to pave the way. Hey, we are kingdom builders, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say, I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say,
hey kids, why are we still standing here? It's this way to KB.
Good morning, KB kids, and welcome to worship today. I am Miss D, and guess what? It is volume number 107. Yes, volume 107, and I am so excited that you have joined me for KB Kids virtual worship today. It has been a whole month since we have seen each other with a brand new episode, and I am excited to dive into our program today. But first and foremost, you know I gotta ask, how was your week? Did you guys have a great week? I hope so. I hope you had a great month, actually. It's been a month. How was your month? Have you guys enjoyed getting back into the routine? I know some of you guys are playing sports, doing different activities. Everybody's back in school by now. I hope all is going well. The weather is changing a little bit if you live here in the Windy City. But you know what? I'm excited. I decided that fall might be my favorite weather. I think I like fall, like a little bit cool, not too hot, you know, maybe a light jacket, maybe some long sleeves like I have on today. But I'm excited about the weather changing. Not so much excited for winter, but we won't talk about that yet. But guys, I am excited to be here with you today because we have a lot of things planned. We are actually on part two of our back to school series. Yes, this is part two. We had part one last month and we are now on part two, and we're going to be learning about the faithfulness of God and also utilizing different things that you might use in school every day to afford us to continue to help us to live the life that God has called us to live. Are you guys excited? I know I am. First and foremost, what do we have to do every single time? We have to say our confessions. Yes. So guys, if you are seated, go ahead and stand up with me and repeat after me. We're going to say confessions together. Say, I love God. I love the Lord Jesus Christ, the blessed Holy Spirit, the things of the Spirit, the Word of God, the work of God, and the people of God, better than I love anything else in all this world. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, let's put on the whole armor of God. Are you guys ready? You're not? Oh, you guys want to do a dancing style? I think we can do a dancing style. All right, I know you guys are excited, so let's go ahead and do our Armor of God dancing style.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Put on your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. You got your armor, guy. Got my belt of truth, check. Breastplate of righteousness. Shoes of peace. Shield of faith. Helmet of salvation. Sword of the Spirit.
You got your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. You got your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. armor done. You got your armor done. Put on your armor done. You got your armor done.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Put on your armor guy. Put on your armor guy. Put on your armor guy. You got your armor guy. Got my belt of truth check. Breastplate of righteousness. Shoes of peace. Shield of faith. Helmet of salvation. Sword of the spirit. Helmet of salvation. Sword of the spirit.
You got your armor done. Put on your armor done. You got your armor done. Put on your armor done. You got your armor done.
Be strong in the Lord and His mighty power. The strength takes care of you when life is sour. Put on the armor of God and fight the enemy. Can you tell me now all the pieces you need? Be strong in the Lord and His mighty power. The strength takes care of you when life is sour. Shoes of peace, shield of faith, helmet of salvation, sword of the spirit, helmet of salvation, sword of the spirit.
Put on your armor done. You got your armor done. Put on your armor done. You got your armor done. You got your armor done. Put on your armor done. You got your armor done.
Be strong in the Lord and His mighty power. The strength takes care of you when life is sour. Put on the armor of God and fight the enemy. Can you tell me now all the pieces you need? Be strong in the Lord and His mighty power. The strength takes care of you when life is sour. Shoes of peace, shield of faith, helmet of salvation, sword of the spirit, helmet of salvation, sword of the spirit.
Put on your armor done. You got your armor done. Put on your armor done. You got your armor done. Put on your armor done. You got your armor done. Put on your armor done. You got your armor done.
Are you ready?
Awesome. I hope you guys are invigorated and ready to go. I have since decided that I will never quite get that dance down 100%, but it doesn't stop me from trying. All right, let's continue our confessions as loud as you can. Say, I am a winner, born to be a leader, to set those captives free, and to lead men in the path of righteousness for His name's sake. Why, you ask? Because I'm a righteous seed. That's right. I hope you guys really understand that you are righteous seed. You are called by God. You are special. You are made in His image. And you are here to show forth His glory here on the earth. Amen? Amen. All right, we're going to get right into praise and worship. Yes, it is praise and worship time. And it is time to lift the name of Jesus higher. Are you guys ready? I hope so. Our first praise and worship song is a new one. We did this a couple weeks ago in live KB worship, but we're going to do it today. It's called I Thank God. It's a dancing song, so I hope you got your dancing shoes ready. Grab a friend and let's sing it together. I thank God.
Hide this weary soul, this vagabond.
Good job, everybody. All right, our next song is One Way. We are talking about the faithfulness of God. We are talking about staying on the straight path that God has called us to be. And there, we know that there's only one way to Jesus. So let's sing it together. One way, Jesus. Jesus loves me. This song will never get old because it reminds me of the sacrifice that Christ made for you and for me, because he loved us so much that he wanted to make sure that we did not die in our sins, but that we could one day be with him. So let's sing it. Jesus loves me.
I have found the love, no heart could frame.
great job, guys. I hope you enjoy praise and worship as much as I do. Nothing else brings me more pleasure than lifting up the name of Jesus. All right, we're going to go ahead, and it is time for story time with Grandma Sandy. Grandma Sandy has a great story that she's going to tell us today about remembering the faithfulness and the blessings of God. So let's listen in with story time with Grandma Sandy.
It's story time!
Hi, boys and girls. Welcome to Story Time with Grandma Sandy. I am so excited about reading the Bible with you today. Now come on, go and get your Bible and meet me at the rocking chair. Welcome back, boys and girls, to Story Time with Grandma Sandy. I am so blessed to be here with you each month. And I thank you for joining me. I am so glad to see all of your shining, beautiful faces. And today, our story will be called The Blessing Folder. Let's jump right into it. There were three boys who lived in a log cabin with their mom and dad. Every night before bed, Mom or Dad would read the boys a true story from the blessing folder. Whenever God would bless their family, Mom and Dad would write the story down and put it in the blessing folder to remind the family to remember and share with others how good our God is and how much He loves us. Tonight was Mom's turn to read a story from the blessing folder, or to tell a new blessing. Mom went to the boys' room and told them, "Boys, let's give thanks for what the Lord has done for our little John. I wrote down the story and titled it The Shining Coin. Do you want to hear it?" The boy said loudly with one thunderous voice, "Yes!" Mom said, "Okay, I'll get the blessing folder." So Mom walked over and she went to the bookcase and she got out the blessing folder. "The title of this story," Mom said, "is The Shiny Coin." Mom called upstairs, "Boys, are you getting ready for bed?" The boys were laughing and playing around and didn't hear Mom's call. The youngest boy, whose name was Little John, spotted a shiny object on the top of the dresser. The sun was shining through the window, making that shiny object very attractive to Little John, who was only 3 years old. Little John wanted to get a closer look at the shiny object, so he looked around to find a chair to stand on. Little John reached his hand up until finally he could grab the shiny object. He looked at it, hit on the dresser, picked it up a few times, turned it over. It was a coin. He wasn't sure how much, but it was a coin. He slowly put it in his mouth. He wanted to taste it. We know that little boys and girls sometimes want to see how things taste. So Little John, he put it in his mouth. And he bit down on it. Oh, he discovered it was very hard, and it tasted dirty. Little John reached for the shiny object to try and take it out of his mouth, but before he could grab it, the shiny object slipped down his throat. Little John began to cough. He really tried hard to bring it up out of his throat. One of Little John's brothers saw Little John was having trouble, and he ran as fast as he could to get his mom. "Mom, come quickly and see Little John. He's coughing and he's hitting his stomach." Little John's mom came running into the room. She said, Little John, are you all right?" Little John miraculously was able to tell his mom that he swallowed some money. That shiny object was money. Mom called out to Dad to come into the room because they needed to talk. Dad came running quickly into the room, and Mom asked Dad to call the doctor so that they would know what to do. Dad called the doctor, and the doctor told Dad to bring Little John to the hospital right away. Mom and Dad asked their neighbor if they could watch the boys. "Of course I can," the neighbor said. "I'll be right over." Mom and Dad were both very calm, and Little John was especially calm. He loved Bible verses, and he asked his mom if he could quote 2 Timothy 1:7. "God has not given me a spirit of fear," Little John said, "but of power and of love and of a sound mind." Little John loved to sing, and he began to sing a song. "God has not given us a spirit of fear. God has not given me a spirit of fear. He has given unto me a spirit of power, a spirit of love, and a sound mind." Mom looked at Little John and gave him a big smile, and Little John kept singing to himself all the way to the hospital. When they reached the hospital, several doctors and nurses were waiting for Little John to arrive, and they took him right into the x-ray room. The doctor showed Mom and Dad the picture of the shiny coin in Little John's throat. The doctor said it was good that the money landed on its side, because if it was any other way, it would have stopped Little John from breathing. Dad lifted his hands and gave God praise. Dad said, "God is always with us." Little John was given some medicine to help him sleep, and the doctors and nurses were able to remove the money from Little John's throat. After they were finished, Little John woke up and began to smile and talk and eat because he was very hungry. That's the end of the blessing folder story. "Wow, Mom," Little John said, "that happened to me. Our God is surely faithful to us." Yes, Little John, our God is very faithful. And boys and girls, I want to tell you that you might want to do a blessing folder. It is good to remember when God does something good for you or your family or your friends or someone you should know. It's good to talk about how the goodness of the Lord and how he brought you through hard times, or how he brought He was with you through good times. It's always good to give a testimony of the goodness of God. Now, boys and girls, I thank you so much for being with us today. And I want you to always remember that I love you, but Jesus loves you more.
It's story time!
Awesome. Good job. Thank you so much, Grandma Sandy, for coming in and reminding us how important it is for us to remember God's blessings. Remember the things that God has done in our lives. Sometimes things get hard and we lose focus and we forget all the things that God has already done in our lives, all the faithfulness that He has shown us. So making sure that you write those down, maybe you put them in a folder like she mentioned, but make sure you remember the blessings that God has given you throughout your life. All right, we're going to go ahead and get to scripture memory. It is time to hide that word in our hearts. All right, we're going to continue with our scripture from last month, Jeremiah 29:11. I think this is such an important scripture that everybody should know. You should know what Christ has done for you, how He has made your path straight, how He continues to work on your behalf to make sure that you have hope and future. All right, we're going to sing our scripture memory song, and then we're going to come back and practice it together. Let's sing.
For I know the plans I have for you, declare.
Plans to give you hope and a future, for I know the plans I have.
verse together. You guys ready? All right, Jeremiah 29:11. This is what it says. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. That is what Christ desires for each and every one of us. As we are walking in his will, as we are walking in his way, he is making our path straight. Doesn't mean there's not speed bumps along the way. Doesn't mean there's not thorns along the path. Doesn't mean that we might not run into debris every now and again. But it means that at the end of the day, Christ is with us. He has made a way for us. He has declared us his children when we have accepted him. And he is going to make our path straight. All right, let's say that one more time. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. Friends, if you did not have hope, I want this scripture to give you hope, knowing that Christ has plans for you. You know, I often like to make plans. I'm a planner. I don't really like to do things, spur of the moment. If you call me up and say, hey, can I do this? Or if my girls say, hey, can we go here? And I'm like, guys, you didn't plan it. You didn't put it on my calendar. I can't do that today. So I'm a planner. So I know what it means to plan. And so Christ has made plans for you. That means he has set good things in your pathway, good things to happen for you in your life, plans to prosper you, not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Take that, sink it in your heart, believe it because it's true. He loves you so much. I hope you guys believe that today. Amen? Amen. Now it is time for Did You Know with Mother Crouch. Mother Crouch is going to share with us some insight, something interesting that she found in the Bible. So let's hear what Mother Crouch has to say with Did You Know?
Did You Know with Mother Crouch.
Hi, kids.
Yes, this is your beloved Mother Crouch. Once again, I know we're talking about book packs, and we're talking about getting ready for school and making sure we got all the essentials. Well, the other day I was doing some studying, and I ran across an interesting story, and I'd like to share it with you. It's in Joshua, the 10th chapter, verse 12 and 13. And I'm reading the New Living Translation. On the day the Lord gave the Israelite victory over the Amorites, Joshua prayed to the Lord in front of all the people of Israel. He said, "Let the sun stand still over Gilead, and the moon over the valley of Ashkelon." So the sun stood still and the moon stayed in place until the nation of Israel had defeated its enemy. And what does that mean, the sun standing still? That means like you can go outside and it never gets dark. You can play forever, be with your friends. The sun actually standing still. And then when the moon comes out, the moon is standing still. And guess what, kids? God did that, and it's proven. I did some more investigative work, and I found it that the scientists found the fact that one day the sun and the moon stood still 3,224 days, way before we was on the scene. It was actually proven. So that says to me that the word of God is correct. Can you just imagine that? The sun never going down? Oh my goodness. The closest that we get to that is in Alaska, where they call it white night, where it just never gets dark. But that's a season that it never gets dark. But I'm telling you, God's word is true. I want to encourage you kids to hide the word of God in your heart. You know, here at Wheaton Christian Center, we do have memory verses in KB. How many of you guys are taking that challenge? How many scriptures you know? How many can you recite word for word, chapter and verse? Hey, why don't you send me an email? It's down below. And tell Mother Crouch what you think about that. Oh, Mother Crouch, I know this. I know this. I know 10 scriptures. Really? Well, share that with me, because I would definitely like to know. All right, then. You know, it's been great talking to you. Hey, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to find some more exciting news about Did you know it from the Bible? I want to tell you kids, have a great day. Bye for now, and I'll see you later.
Did you know with Mother Crouch?
Awesome. Thank you so much, Mother Crouch. I always appreciate the insight and the different ways that and the different interesting things that you point out to us from Scripture. All right, guys, it is announcement time, and I am super excited because we have a very special event coming up at the end of this upcoming month, October. October 31st, you guys know what it is. It is Hallelujah Night. Now, it is on a Monday this year, but we are excited. We are going to be here. We are excited to celebrate with you guys because even though the world decided to do it one way, we, KB Kids, we as Christians are going to do it another way. We're going to have a Hallelujah party right here at WCC, and we don't want you to miss it. Everybody is invited. You can bring your friends from school. You can bring your neighbor friends. You can bring your cousins. You can bring anybody you want. We're going to dress up in nice, wholesome costumes. You can make, you can be a superhero. You can be a character from your favorite book. You can be a character from the Bible. Whatever it is, you can dress up as nice, wholesome characters. And we're going to have a special, prize for the one who wins the dress-up portion of our evening. It's going to be lots of fun. It's going to be candy. It's going to be food. It's going to be games. It's going to be a great time in the Lord. So I don't want you guys to miss it. We will have more information upcoming, but make sure you mark your calendars for Monday, October 31st. You're right here at WCC for Hallelujah Night. Amen? Amen. All right, let's go ahead and say our confessions. It is time to give. If your parents text to give, they can use the information here on the screen. Repeat after me. Say, Father, I thank you as we obey your word in giving and receiving. I thank you that all our needs are met and that we are blessed to be a blessing to your people. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. All right, guys, it is lesson time, and we are talking about ways that we can be prepared for this upcoming school year and that we can be prepared for life. So last week, we talked about things in our backpack, right? We talked about pencils. We talked about a notebook and ways that we can utilize those in our everyday life to help us stay organized and stay on track. Now, today, we're talking about importance of folders and rulers. Okay, I know you guys know what a folder is. I know many of you in the younger grades, you might have a take-home folder where the teacher will say, you know, all the work that you've done or maybe some homework that you have to do. So a folder is very important to keep you organized. And you know what a folder does for me? I love to look at my nephew's folders when they come home. I check their folders because I want to see all the things that they did. I want to be reminded about what they did throughout the day. So I might say, hey, Aiden, how was school today? And he might say, let me check my folder and see what I did. And he's remembering what he did based on what's inside his folder. Or I might say, hey, Gabe, like, how was school today? And Gabe will come and he'll say, look what I did. And he'll pull something out of his folder. Even my littlest nephew, Ethan, also has a folder. So you know what? Folders are really good for organization and to remind you of all the things that happen throughout the day. And you know what? Rulers are great for what? Yeah, they help you stay on the straight and narrow. Like, I know I've never been able to really make a straight line. I always need a ruler or some kind of, you know, edge to make a straight line. And rulers help us to stay on track. If we're doing math, if we're doing art projects, like if you need a ruler for something, it'll help you stay on track. It will give you the right measurements. It'll help you make straight, even lines. It'll help you to stay organized in your assignment. So folders and rulers are really important to stay on track in school. And you know what? That's what we're talking about in life as well. You know, we're talking about the faithfulness of God. We're talking about how we can trust what God is telling us because we know that he's faithful. All right, I have a question for you. What are these? You guys know what these are? Yeah, these are Oreo cookies. Well, at least they say they're Oreo cookies. Now, if you look at this package, you're probably thinking, I've had Oreos before. I know what those are. But what if you open them up and they were like chocolate chip cookies? And you're just like, wait, what? This says Oreo cookies. Why am I eating chocolate chip cookies? You'd be so confused. And maybe the next time you went to open a package of Oreo cookies, you would be a little bit hesitant. You're like, ah, I don't trust that these are Oreos. I don't know if they're telling me the right thing. You know, I have a story for you. Back when I lived in Zimbabwe, I bought a package of Oreo cookies at the store in Zimbabwe. I opened it up, I took a bite, and I was like, these do not taste like Oreo cookies. Now, granted, they were just a little bit different because I bought them from a different country, so they use different types of ingredients and all of that. But I was a little skeptical, and I can honestly say I did not eat another Oreo cookie while I was there in Zimbabwe. I just didn't care for them. But you know what? If I open this pack up right now, I bet that I'm gonna find some Oreo cookies. Yep, in fact, I found some Oreo cookies. So now I know that I can trust what the packaging is telling me because I have seen it for my own eyes. I have tasted it. I know that what they say is on the outside is also going to be on the inside. And you know, it's like that with God. If you remember back to the things that God has done for you, that God has done for your family, that God has done for your friends, you will be reminded of his faithfulness. You won't doubt that what he says, he's going to do. You know, that's what our lesson is about today. God's faithfulness and how he keeps us on the straight and narrow, how he keeps us on the path that we are to go. And a story that reminds me of that in the Bible is the story of Joshua and the Battle of Jericho. So we're going to check it out with our animated video, and then we'll come back and talk about it a little bit more.
Israel came closer to their promised land. As they camped overlooking the fertile valley of their soon-to-be home, God showed them the strong city of Jericho. It was a fortified city with big, thick walls that prevented enemy soldiers from capturing it. For Israel to take possession of the land, this city had to be destroyed. Once again, God raised up a strong and courageous leader named Joshua. God told him to take charge of the people of Israel and lead them into the promised land. Joshua secretly sent two spies to scout out the land and the city. They were to report back to him. This would give him great information on which he could plan their attack. God told Joshua to put the armed men in front, followed by the priests blowing their trumpets and the Ark of the Covenant. At the back, another guard of soldiers were to stand. All these people were then to march around Jericho once a day for 6 days. The trumpets would blow, but the people were not allowed to make any noise, not even a word. Then on the seventh day, they were to march around the city 7 times and on Joshua's signal, shout as loud as they could. On the morning of the seventh day, Joshua, the army, the priests, and the people did exactly as the Lord commanded. On their seventh circle around the city, Joshua gave the signal, and the people erupted in shouts. Their yelling was met with a huge rumble as the city walls of Jericho began to break apart and tumble down. They burned the city to the ground, but kept all the gold and silver and placed it into the treasury of the Lord. They did, however, spare the lives of Rahab and her family, since Rahab helped the Israelite spies when they came to scout out the city. Once again, God gave the Israelites victory. A curse was placed on the city, and to this day, the walls of Jericho have never been rebuilt.
Guys, I love that story. It is one of the more popular stories in the Bible, but it just reminds me of God's faithfulness. God was faithful to Israel, even when they disobeyed him, even when they went their own way, even when they worshiped other gods, when they did all the things they weren't supposed to do, God still had plans for them, and it was plans to prosper them, not to harm them. While they were in the desert, they were not harmed. They were out in the open, and other people could have come and fought against them and killed them, but they were not harmed. God took care of them, and he had plans to prosper them. He had plans to give them the land that was flowing with milk and honey. And Joshua at one point had to remind the Israelites of all of God's faithfulness. Remember when he led us out of Egypt. Remember when he parted the Red Sea. Remember when he gave us manna in the desert. They were remembering all of God's faithfulness. So they had to know that even when they were about to go up against the people of Jericho, who were giants and they were huge and scary, he reminded them that God had been with them in the past and that he was going to be with them even now. Isn't that a great reminder? Remind yourself of all the things that God has done for you so that you know that you can trust him. You know, when you open up that package, when you open up your Bible, that the words in there are true because God has proven them to you over and over again. I can't tell you how many times God has proven his love for me, his provision for me, his care for me in so many ways. I could write books and books and books about it because I know without a shadow of a doubt that he has plans to prosper me, not to harm me, to give me a hope and a future. And that is what I want for you guys. I want you guys to know that you know that you know that he is faithful. Amen? Amen. All right, we're going to go ahead and get into our puppet friends. We have a hilarious skit with the puppet friends, and they're going to share with us a little bit more about our lesson today. So puppet friends, take it away.
Welcome to Courage Mall. Can I help you? Baskin Robbins? Straight ahead, please. Thank you. Next. Hello, welcome to Courage Mall. The candy barrel? Straight ahead, please. Thank you. Next. Hello, welcome to Courage Mall. What can I help? Movie theater? How exciting. What are you here to see? Oh, I want to see that one myself. Just go straight ahead to ticketing and then straight ahead to concessions and straight into your theater. Don't forget the junior mints.
Afternoon, Ted.
Good afternoon, Ellie.
That's Miss Douglas, please.
Miss Douglas. Next. I'm sorry, what was that? Stride right shoes? Straight ahead.
Ted, have you been telling everyone who needs directions to go straight that way, like down the west wing?
Yes, I have.
Ted, you do know we have four wings in the mall, right?
Certainly.
And not everything is straight ahead?
But you know what they say?
No. What do they say?
Next. Hello, welcome to Courage Mall. Radio Shack? Straight ahead, please.
No, it's not straight ahead.
Yes, it is.
It's in the south wing to the left of the escalators.
Pay no attention to the worldly voices behind me. It's straight ahead.
It is not straight ahead.
Yes, it is.
Ted, you're sending everyone to Kentucky Fried Chicken.
I am?
Yes.
Why? That's not good.
You got a good reason why you're telling people to go straight?
Sure I do. The straight and narrow is the road to heaven. And if we trust in the Lord, he'll make all our paths straight.
Wait, he will?
That's what my pastor said just this morning.
Oh, that's beautiful, Ted.
Thank you.
Now, if anyone comes here and asks for the directions in life, that's exactly what you should tell them. But if they ask for the directions to the Orange Julius...
Straight ahead.
No, it's to the north wing next to the Cinnabon.
Dagnabbit.
Game time, and I'm super excited to play a game with you guys. So sit back and relax. It's an animated game today. So go ahead and relax and put your mental capacity to work because we're going to have some fun today. Are you guys ready? All right, here we go.
Oh, yeah. This is going to be sweet. Go ahead and stand up if you're ready to play the tie game. I know what you're thinking. This is a game where everybody wins because no matter what, it ends in a tie. Wrongo! You can totally win, and you can totally lose. The rules are simple. I'll show you several identical boxes. One of those boxes will have a stylish necktie inside. Ooh. You'll need to summon all your powers of concentration to keep track of the box with the tie. If you can do it, well done. You'll find yourself moving on to the next round. If you lose the tie, you can keep playing, but please take a seat. All right, let's get this party started! Well, that's it for round one. Shout out one, two, or three, depending on where you think the tie is. Nice work. Let's try round two. Ah, little harder that time, wasn't it? Shout out one, two, or three, if you know where it is. Cool. There's the tie. Now, let's see if you can do it with four boxes. Okay, you know the drill. Where do you think the tie is? Bravo, you found it. It's only gonna get harder from here, though. Ah, that's a real head scratcher. Yeah, well, what do you think? Which box has the tie? Good news, bad news time. Good news, you found the tie. Bad news, the next round has five boxes. Whoa, I'm more confused than that time I tried to watch a movie with no sound. Does anybody know where the tie is? All right, final round, here we come. You guys know where it is, right? I actually need that tie back. Oh, wow! Glad somebody was paying attention. You guys are pretty good at that. Maybe we'll play again sometime.
Awesome, guys. Great job. I hope you are victorious in our game today. All right, last but not least, we're going to do our Bible trivia. We want to be Bible scholars. We want to be those kids that know our Bible facts left and right. Those KB kids, those kids are smart. All right, so go ahead and play along with our Bible trivia today. See if you can get all the answers correct. And we'll be right back to finish up our lesson.
Hi there, friends. Oh, how many of you love donuts? Deep-fried, sugary goodness. I love them, too. But do you know what food I do not love? Jelly donuts! Do not give me donuts with jelly. Like, ew. Give me chocolate, blueberry, cake, or even maple bacon. But you can keep the jelly to yourself. Why am I telling you all of this? Well, it turns out I have 18 identical donuts. 12 of them are jelly. We'll call those the Dirty Dozen. I need your help to find the 6 real donuts. To do that, I'm going to ask you some Bible trivia questions. Each question will have 3 answers represented by donuts. 2 of the answers will be wrong. Those are the jelly donuts. But the correct answer is the good, pure, non-jelly-filled donut. All you have to do is shout out the correct answer when you see it. Think you can help me out? Great! Here's the first question. How many commandments did God give to Moses? A. 12. B. 10. C. 152. Remember, shout out A, B, or C when you think you know the answer. Okay, time's up. The correct answer is B. God gave Moses 10 commandments. Nice work. We got rid of 2 of those jelly donuts. Only 10 more to go. The first commandment says we should have no other what before me? A. Cats. B. Money. C. Gods. What do you think? A, B, or C? Time's up. The correct answer is C. The first commandment says you shall have no other gods before me. Nice job. Oh, which commandment says we should not steal? A. Number 2. B. Number 5. C. Number 8. Shout out your answer now! A, B, or C? Time is up! The correct answer is C again. The 8th commandment says you shall not steal. Oh, we're halfway there. Only 3 questions to go. What does the 9th commandment tell us to avoid? A. Lying. B. Snoring. C. Hitting. I don't nut know. What do you think? A, B, or C? Okay, time's up! The correct answer is A. The 9th commandment tells us not to lie. Well done! Here's the next question. What does the 4th commandment tell us to do on the Sabbath day? A. Work really hard. B. Keep it holy and rest. C. Buy donuts. Shout out your answer now! A, B, or C? Time is up! The correct answer is B. The 4th commandment tells us to honor the Sabbath by keeping it holy and taking time to rest. Here comes the last question. If I'm really jealous of my friend's box of donuts, which commandment am I breaking? A. Number 1. B. Number 5. C. Number 10. What do you think? Is it A, B, or C? Okay, time's up! The correct answer is C. The 10th commandment tells us not to covet or be jealous of what others have. Well done, everyone! Thanks for helping me sort out all of those gross jelly donuts.
So much for joining me. I can't believe it is already over. This lesson just flew by. I can't wait till next month. We are getting into some different lesson for next month, so stay tuned to hear about that. We're going to be talking a little bit more about thankfulness and all those things that are coming up. But I can't wait until next month, so make sure that you like and subscribe and join us to make sure that you know when a new episode is going to drop for KB Kids. And you can peruse the old episodes because those are always good as well. All right, let's pray together to end up our session together. Father, I thank you for this time that we've had together. I thank you for allowing us to get into your word and understand how much you love us. We understand that you have plans for us, plans to prosper us, not to harm us, to give us hope and a future. Help us to walk in confidence, knowing that you are making our path straight. And even when there's speed bumps in the road or there's things to the right or to the left, that you are holding us, you are keeping us, and that you are faithful to do those things that you have set out for us to do. We love you and we thank you for loving us. Bless all of those who are listening today until we're able to meet again. We love you. We thank you for loving us. In Jesus' name, amen, 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 amen. Well, guys, I'm so excited you joined me for virtual worship today. I cannot wait until next month. Make sure, once again, you like, subscribe, and turn on those notifications so you know when a brand new episode of KB Kids is about to drop. Until next time, you know what I got to do. It's me, Miss D, signing off. Bye for now.
KB baby kids affecting the world around us positively. We are growing day by day. We are watching what we say. We are kingdom builder kids and we're here to pave the way. Hey, we are kingdom builders, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say, I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say, I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. One more time, we are. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KB Kids out. Wheaton Christian Center, Kingdom Builders, Children's Ministry.